Hey everyone, welcome to CS Dojo. My name is YK and I'm your host. And today we're going to talk about the top 5 programming languages to learn for getting a job at companies like Google, Facebook, Microsoft, etc. So the obvious question here might be, does it really matter which languages you learn if you're trying to get a job at one of these companies? My answer would be, yes it does, but not directly. What I mean by that is when you have a job interview with one of these companies as a software engineer candidate, the most important thing they'll usually look for is not what specific language or technology you've been using. Instead, they tend to look for mostly your coding skills, your problem-solving ability, and your data structures and algorithms knowledge. So you might say, wait, YK, so it doesn't really matter which languages I learn then? My answer to that would be, actually, it still matters a lot. I'm going to explain my reasoning behind that in this video, but if you just want to find my list, just skip over to this time in this video. Okay, so if these large companies don't care that much about which languages you know, then why does it matter at all which languages you learn if you want to get a job at one of these companies? There are three reasons for this. Reason number one, when you apply for a job at one of these big companies, how do you think they'll decide if they should invite you for a job interview? Of course, there are a few different aspects to this. For example, your education, your personal projects, and so on. But the biggest factor is usually your work experience. And how do you get that experience in the first place? Probably at smaller, less known companies first. And actually, smaller companies and startups tend to care more about which specific language or technology you know. So for example, a small startup might say, we need someone who can help us create an iOS app tomorrow. Or we need someone who knows JavaScript really well by next month. So depending on which languages you know, it'll actually be easier or harder for you to get a job at one of these smaller companies. And reason number two, I think you should learn a programming language that aligns with your interests so you have more motivation and reason for learning. So for example, if you're interested in learning to make an iPhone app, you should probably learn Swift. And if you're interested in data science, machine learning, or science in general, Python might be a good choice for you. Reason number three, some programming languages are simply easier to learn than some other ones. For example, I would say JavaScript is easier to learn than Java, and Python is easier to learn than C++. So based on that, I decided to use the job market and ease of learning as the two main criteria for making my list of top 5 programming languages to learn. Okay, so here's my list. Number 5, Ruby. Ruby is a programming language from Japan. It became popular due to the popularity of something called Ruby on Rails, and Ruby on Rails was at some point, I would say, the hottest framework for building websites, although it's not as popular as it used to be anymore. Still, a lot of companies use Ruby on Rails today, and Ruby is a really simple and easy language to learn. Number 4, Swift. Swift is now the primary language for building an iOS app, whether it's for iPhone or iPad. If you have this skill, it should be fairly easy for you to get a job since many companies want to build iOS apps. I haven't used this language extensively myself, but it seems like a fairly simple and easy language to learn. The only downside of Swift is that it's not really cross-platform, meaning it's not easy to create an iOS app with Swift if you don't have a Mac. Number 3, Java. Java is probably one of the most widely used programming languages today. You can use Java to build many things, including Android apps. Many companies use Java frameworks to create websites as well. Unfortunately, it's not the easiest language to learn since it's a bit more complex than the other languages in this list. Number 2, Python. Python is also a very popular programming language, at least in North America, and many companies use it to create websites with frameworks like Django and Flask. This is probably the language of your choice if you're interested in things like data science, machine learning, or science in general. It's also one of the main languages used at Google, so it's popular at both large companies and smaller companies. And number 1, JavaScript. JavaScript used to be a language that only ran on your browser, whether it's Chrome, Firefox, or Safari, but recently, people started using it to create backend code, meaning the code that runs on your servers, not just frontend code, meaning the code that runs on your device, whether it's a phone or a laptop. JavaScript is a great language to learn for getting a job, and it's also fairly simple and easy to learn. Now, if you're just getting started with programming, I'd recommend that you start with either Python or JavaScript. And I think your optimal choice here mostly depends on your interests. For example, if you're interested in UI or user experience design, then JavaScript is probably the way to go. If you're more into logic, machine learning, or science in general, Python might be the right choice for you. Now, I have three more languages for honorable mentions, but I have a quick announcement to make. I've just launched my Patreon page where you can chip in a few dollars to join a private Facebook group and a private monthly live stream where you can ask me any questions. I'd much appreciate it if you could head over to csdojo.io/PAT to support my channel. So here's my honorable mention number one, Go, which is also known as Golang. This language was originally developed at Google, but it's used extensively in many companies today. Go is known for its efficiency and its simple syntax, and it's actually becoming one of the most popular programming languages today. So if you're looking to add a language to your skill set, this is the first language I'd definitely consider. Honorable mention number two, Kotlin. Kotlin is a relatively new language, and it works in both a Java-based environment and a JavaScript-based environment. Kotlin was recently officially supported by Android, so it's possible that Kotlin will become the primary language for developing Android apps in the future. Honorable mention number three, SQL, which some people pronounce as SQL. If you search for what programming languages to learn, you might run across an article or two that mentions SQL. But if you're a beginner, it might be confusing because SQL is different from all the other languages that we talked about in this video. SQL or SQL is a programming language that's solely focused on managing databases. It's usually used in conjunction with one of the other languages. So learning SQL as your first programming language is probably not the best idea. And in my opinion, it's not that easy to learn SQL without having some real-life data to play with. So I'd focus on learning other languages first. Okay, that's all I have for this video. Thanks as always for watching. And again, I'd much appreciate it if you could head over to my Patreon page right here to support CS Dojo. And let me know in the comment below if you have any requests about what kind of videos I should make in the future. And I'll see you in the next video.